Hosting 300,000 people in Brighton was a dirty job, especially for our beautiful beach. But this year, several hundred people responded to the appeal of Big Pride Beach Clean, probably the biggest volunteer beach cleanup of all times in Brighton, was sponsored by Brighton Hove Pride and delivered by Ocean 8 on the Sunday morning while the celebration of the Pride were still on.
We were here really, really early on the Sunday morning after the main Pride event. We had the Ocean's 8 team split across two locations, one being here outside the Brighton Dolphin Project by the Palace Pier, and the other team were located outside the Tempest Inn on the other side of the pier. So yeah, we had 34 volunteers or so on each location, plus a huge amount of volunteers as well.
Who organised so many people?
It was a group effort organising so many people. Ocean's 8 is a collective of eight, and actually nine, we're Ocean's 8 plus one, females who work across the whole of the city, and we work in the environmental sector in some capacity, so some through art, some through design, some through consultancy, but we all have a marine emphasis and a waste emphasis. So we organise the beach clean in collaboration with Pride and also supported with Bupa as well. So it was, we think, the biggest ever beach clean to be mobilised on Brighton Beach, which is incredible.
Have you got any stats? I mean, tons of rubbish you collected.
Yeah, we've got some fantastic stats on the day. As many people know, there was a huge amount of influx of visitors to the city, which obviously means there's a huge amount of waste that's going to be produced. So on the beach clean itself, across the two sites, we picked up just over 2 tonnes of waste from the beach. But what was really important about this beach clean in particular is that because of the amount of volunteers we had, we could split that waste into stuff that could be recycled and stuff that has to go to incineration. Usually on beach cleans of this volume, and when city cleans do beach cleans, everything just ends up going to the incinerator because they just do not have the time to split it off. So we ended up diverting 1.5 tonnes to the recycling, and then just over 0.5 tonne that will have to go to incineration.
What sort of rubbish have you guys collected?
The rubbish was a variety of different things. Lots of single-use items. We found a lot of cans, as you would expect from party goes generally. This happens every sunny weekend on the seafront. We found a lot of plastic pint glasses and half-pint glasses. We found balloons. We found nitrous oxide canisters. We found general waste that you get on a beach clean, which is things that people have lost, as well as toys and random objects. So it was a huge variety. Takeaway containers as well, from people having something to eat and sitting on the beach in it, blowing away or getting left behind. So a variety, but everything was basically single use apart from the lost property. There was a large amount of nitrous oxide canisters that were collected on the beach clean. This is very usual of any beach clean. I'm also a regional rep for Surfers Against Sewage, and we do beach cleans along the seafront quite regularly. And we do find quite a lot of these nitrous oxide canisters. There was quite a large collection of them, and I think what was most visible about this beach clean is we were separating these off. Quite often these go straight into the general waste, so you don't see them. They're made from steel, so you can actually recycle these, but we were splitting them off, and they're going to be going to an artist, one of the team, plus a couple of others who are actually going to be reusing the material. There are places you can recycle them, but there's not many of them. So I think with this beach clean, it was just very visible because we were actually splitting them off. And I think there was around 150 kilos of the nitrous oxide canisters alone that we diverted from incineration.
So Glastonbury went plastic free this year. Do you think Pride should do the same?
Glastonbury went plastic free, but a lot of people did see there was a huge amount of plastic that people still brought in onto the site. So the organisers did a huge amount to try and encourage people to be single-use plastic free, but it is very, very difficult. That's what Glastonbury demonstrated. A good thing about Glastonbury is it's a closed environment. So when we think about trying to monitor the amount of plastic use that we have and try and contain it, Glastonbury can do that. The difficulty with Pride is that it's split over so many different locations across the city. We have the main party up at Preston Park, and actually there was a deposit return scheme with a reusable cup, which is brilliant. The organisers set that up for this year. We yet to get stats about how people reacted to that, but generally when we've done similar things elsewhere in the country, they've been really well received. But Pride itself is a city-wide celebration. That's what makes it so wonderful and so special and so inclusive. It's not just for people who are ticket holders, it's for everybody. So to be able to police something and go completely plastic-free is like asking the whole of Brighton and Hove to go plastic-free overnight. It's very tricky, but there are lots of steps that are already being taken to make sure we're reducing the amount of single-use plastic, even if we don't get rid of all of it. The only last thing I'd like to add is just to say a massive thank you to everybody who actually came down. This was, for me, the earliest beach clean I've ever been involved in. We were here at 5:30 in the morning. Volunteers were here at the same sort of time, and we had people coming to the beach clean from 7 o'clock. And anybody who went out for Pride knows how much of a thing it is to be up at 7 o'clock in the morning to come and do a beach clean. So a huge thank you to all of our volunteers. Over 500, maybe 600 people turned up and pitched in, everything from an hour to 10 hours of their time. So a huge, huge thank you to them. We wouldn't have been able to do it without them.